life. No one comes through the Father except through Him. Amen. Let's declare He is the way and He is the only way. Yes, Jesus.
I lay my life down at Your feet. You're the only one I need. I turn to You and You are always there.
Amen.
In troubled times, it's You I see. I put You first, that's all I need. I humble all I am, all to You.
Amen.
One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for.
Yes, Jesus, You're always there, Lord. Change, oh God.
You will never ever change. Yesterday, today, the same. Forever till forever meets no end.
Come on, let's declare one way.
One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for.
Once again.
One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for.
Yes, let's sing again. You're always there, oh God. Thank You, Jesus.
'Cause You are always, always there. Anyhow and everywhere. So grace abounds so deeply within me.
Thank You, Jesus.
'Cause You will never ever change. Yesterday, today, the same.
Amen.
Forever till forever meets no end.
Yes, Jesus.
One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live.
Once again.
It's one way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for. One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for.
You are the way, the truth, and the life. Live by faith and not by sight. For You,
we'll live it all for You.
Come on, let's sing it. You are the way, Lord.
Yes, You are the way, the truth, and the life. We'll live by faith and not by sight. For You, we'll live it all for You.
Once again, let's declare, You are the way, Lord.
You are the way, the truth, and the life. We live by faith and not by sight. For You, we live it all for You.
For the last time, You are the way.
You are the way, the truth, and the life. We live by faith and not by sight. For You, we live it all for You. One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for.
Amen.
One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could.
For the last time, one way.
One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could live for.
Amen.
One way, Jesus, You're the only one that I could.
Heart's desire, O God, and we long to worship You, Jesus.
water, so my soul longed after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. For you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. 'Cause you alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. Once again, as the deer, as the deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. Let's say it to Jesus. Desire, and I long to worship. We love you more than gold, Jesus. I love you more than gold or silver. Only you can satisfy. No one else, Jesus. You the real joy giver and the apple of my eye. Let's worship. 'Cause you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You desire, and I long to worship. Let's say, you're my friend. Thank you, Lord. 'Cause you're my friend, and you are my brother. Even though you are a king, we love you more than any other. I love you more than any other, so much more than anything, Jesus. You alone, is you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit. Jesus, 'cause you alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee, and I long
to worship thee, our hearts, Lord, and I long to worship thee.
Shalom community, welcome to a very long weekend, and I know we have something coming up karong tomorrow or the day after. We will spend some time with our family, perhaps spend some time talking about people who have passed away, or mga tao nga we hold dear in our hearts that are no longer with us. That's why we are going to have a very long weekend. And ato ang focus for today, we'll be discussing about these holidays, ganong naataanin, and how we can redeem those and use them for God's glory. And our scripture verse for today is found in Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 to 2. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God. Before we start today, let's bow our heads first. Let's pray. Lord God, we'd like to thank you for today. Dighang salamat, Lord, for you have given us much time to be able to celebrate and use these days and use them productively. Use them in a way that deepens our relationship with you. Use them in a way that refreshes our journey here on earth. So Lord, we thank you for this time. May this sermon, may this message give us a benefit in terms of moving forward after this long weekend. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Our sermon for today is entitled, A Great Cloud of Witnesses. We may be wondering, why are we celebrating All Souls Day and All Saints Day? Some people, including some businesses, even participate in kanilang mga Halloween month na i-promo for the Halloween and mga all these other things. Now, we do know that most of what we are celebrating for October 31, November 1, and November 2 are celebrations not in connection with anything in the Bible. But it doesn't mean na if we participate on them, or di kaya we celebrate them, or we avail of certain promos and certain holidays, immediately it becomes evil. We must remember that there's a much deeper meaning, and actually we can redeem those days and use them, that is, use them in a way that is beneficial. Now, ang focus nato today will not be discussing about those, but discussing about how we can use those days. Now, it started actually in a Samhain, a Celtic or a Celtic Samhain festival na dugay na kaayo before. It happened thousands of years ago. This was actually a tradition because during those days, kani October 31 to November 1, nagatuo sila during these days that the people who are dead or the spirit world will be able to push through the physical world. And ang physical people, kita who live on this earth, are able to touch and communicate with the spiritual world. Naay mo rag certain opening na kaning adlawa lang ni that they are able to communicate with us, and mohawa na po sila after this day. So the Celtic people celebrated this by festivals, and naa sila'y food gina-prepare, naa sila'y celebration and all those things. Actually, it was a tradition for them na usually they would spend this time with their family or their clans or with their relatives. And then what they would do is mag-prepare sila ug pagkaon outside their doors, so as to whoever would visit, mukaon. If you remember, later on, matransform na into trick or treat or naihatag candies if mag-visit kaning mga na with costume, Halloween costume na mga tao. And now we notice that naay mga masks and naay mga costumes. Actually, nagikan dyan na siya originally with that, because during this time, since they believe the spirits would come, if ever kinahanglan sila magawa sila mga balay on October 31 leading towards November 1, they will wear kaning mga scary na mga costumes and mga masks, so as to camouflage, to disguise themselves. Di sila mailhan by the spirits nga tao sila, and it may be ma-endanger sila. So mugawa sila wearing this para mo nag dili sila mabantayan. O di sila wala malas na moadto sa ila, so to speak. So with that, nahimo na siyang tradition until later on during the 9th century. There was a pope, Pope Gregory IV, gimove niya ang isa ka festival from May 13 to November 1, gibangga niya, which is All Saints Day. It was supposed to be a day para sa tanang mga tao who passed away, tanang tao na namatay. It was a day to commemorate them, to remember them, to visit the cemetery and other places, to remember what these people that have passed away. Now, gimove niya dito in order to combat, gibangga niya, sa kaning festival in the Halloween. Now, so, dikit na ni sila, November 1 and November 2. Merog natapad na sila because of that. Gibangga during those days. That's why, 2 days sila magsabay. So, ang uban at midweek na merog Halloween and then All Saints Day and then napoy All Souls Day. That's why na-sandwich ng mga adlawan na. And then later on 16th century, nagsugod ang trend na mga batanon would go out and collect or wear kanyang mga costumes and mga scary na mga sanina in order to celebrate kanyang mga adlawa. And if we follow history, dili lang kana ang nahitabo during those span of 2 days. Actually, naapoy very something important, which is, I don't think, a coincidence na maupuning adlaw. Because it was also November 1, ang usaka event that really started a fire with regards to where we are now as Christians. Because on November 1, it was this day that Martin Luther, a monk, a Catholic monk, pinned down his 95 theses on the door of the Roman Catholic Church. And the reason why, nga nung gipin niya ni, gibutang niya ni kaning listahan, because those were 95 arguments he had going against the Catholic Church. Because it was during this time na the Roman Catholics were prohibiting, bawal ang mga tao na mubasag Biblia. In fact, it was only in Latin. If you read the Bible, interpret, naka-interpretation, you will be killed. Pwede ka kulungun or patyun ka. In fact, naghan na ng mga priests during this time because they studied Latin. And the more they opened scripture, the more they learned about the Bible, na-realize nila nga ang tao bandi ay pwede man di maka-directly connect with God. But the Catholic Church, gipugna nila ni, they wanted na na-mediator always mga tao. Kami mga priests, kami mga pope, nalang sa mong interpretation, kami lang makasabot sa Biblia, kami lang makatuon ani, kami lang pwede mo quote ani, bawal mo magamit ani. And if ever mo gamit mo, you are destroying the Word of God, the Holy Word of God, you shall be put to death. Daghan na kayo na nga matay because they wanted people to learn about the Bible. And so, mga tao, nagyangungo lang sila tanan. They were waiting for the priests and the Pope from the Bible because sila, bawal sila mubasa sa Biblia. Na si Martin Luther, the one who pinned this on the Roman Catholic Church on November 1, for him, the more he learned about the Bible, realized niya nga, di man dapat nato pugan ang mga tao na makaila sa Ginoo, makabaton o relasyon sila. Because everything we're practicing is against the very Word of God. So, gibuhat niya, gipin niya, gilista niya, unsay mga mali na sa atong ginabuhat. Obviously, he was excommunicated, itanggal siya from the, he ran away, nitaka siya, nihawa siya, para di siya kulungon, para di siya patyun. Because he had peers, na siya mga mentors during this time, na gipang patay po because of this. So, that started a revolution. To make the long story short, niabot sa point, na niabot na ni mga translators, niabot na ni mga people who translated the Bible into different languages, particularly English and German and Chinese, para mga tao makasabot sa Biblia. Until niabot na sa atuang time that we are able to enjoy the very Word of God. Now, this is important because knowing this history, perhaps nasa atong mind, ngano niabot ni Bible sa tuwa? Why is it in English? Ngano natay Bisaya version? Ngano natay Tagalog version? The verse reminds us that we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses. This great cloud of witnesses meaning, dili ta Christians only for this generation. Niabot na ani na point because there were so many generations before us. People who gave up their lives, people who were persecuted, suffered in prison. We are not single generation Christians. We have come from a very long line of believers. Niabot na ani na point because of these so many people who have sacrificed basically ilang reputation, ilang way to earn money, ilang life, para lang jud ang mga tao makabalo about sa Ginoo. And so, it has been passed down to us now as people who live in the year 2022, as believers and Christians now, we are living in this generation knowing na gikan to sa pinakalayo kaayo nga history. In fact, in Hebrews 12, which is the focus today, speaks about not only what happened kaning sa Martin Luther na time or kaning history nato, but actually it comes from thousands of years of different Christians. Even those na gibasa, both gibasa nato sa Bible, and those that are not included in the Bible but are popular in history. So, in Hebrews chapter 11, the chapter before the 12, kitang i-focus na to, karon na scripture verse, naka-outline diya so many people who have gone through their journey of faith. Kaning faith nila, because they have faith, nag-result into action. And so, naa sila Abraham, sila Moses, and all these other people. And it just shows na mali na thinking na atuang belief, ang atong faith is only limited to one generation. Karon lang. Pag-learn lang karon, pag-interpret karon, we must always look back. Asa yung tagikan? Ang sinahitabo sa una? Ngano tanaan na point? The more we learn about history, the more we learn about ourselves. We solidify our identity if we learn about our history. That's why bitaw sometimes we have these certain things na mag-visita sa ato mga lolo and lola or sa great-grandfathers nato. We look at our hometown, mag-visita wherever asa tagikan. To solidify our identity, we learn from these stories and understand many things. In fact, that's one of the things in cultures such as China, nga lalum sa ilaha ang identity asa gikan. That's why they have trips na i-arrange nila for you para maadto dyan mo asa imong hometown, imong roots if you have Chinese blood. So, big deal na sa ilaha because they want to solidify this full identity kung kinsa ka by knowing your roots, knowing asa ka gikan, asa mo niabot mo ani na point, so you retrace your steps. One of the things that is great about our Christian faith is because of this, because we have so great crowd of witnesses, actually there are thousands of stories gawa sa Bible that are spoken to encourage our faith. Daghan kay mga biographies, mini biographies, if you have been with us for a long time here in the community, daghan ta na mention ng mga tao, people who have gone through different time periods, napos sila ilahang moments of suffering, napos sila moments nila where they exercise their faith and share the word of God. You've gone through lain-laing mga issues at that time. And so daghan kaayo na. It's actually a great practice that we involve ourselves having at least one biography na mahuman nato in a year. Dako na kay nag-impact sa imong life. If you know, if pangutanon nimo anyone who has really gone all in, mga people who really, believers who really understood and followed the word of God for a very long period of time, decades, many of them are inspired or continually inspired by at least one person na wala sa Bible. Someone who has made an impact to them, na ay missionary or na ay pastor, na ay a common man who had undergone persecution or lahing time period, mas simple nag-inspire sa ilaha to continue on sa ilang faith. That's why it's a great investment mo palitan ng mga biographies. You can start with the little ones, mga gagmay nga biography, and learn to piece your way into history kung asa ni unsay mga challenges na agi na nila during this time. That's why I really like to visit also desiringgod.org, kaning ministry na gi-start ni John Piper, because each quarter or at least half a year, naasli mga conference, or I think annually na karon once a year, ang conference sila is centered around one person in history, unsay naagihan niya, iyang suffering, iyang gibuhat niya, iyang investment niya towards the literature na to sa Christian literature, or di kaya pila ka years ang invest sa mission field. And then we study their life and we understand how they are going through kani mga struggles sila each and every day and how that impacted po sa ilahang trabaho. So it's really good habit that we do by following and reading up kani mga biographies. That's why we have All Saints Day, because we must connect that towards our past asa ta karon. That's why our scripture verse reminds us, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, because there is really great benefit in remembering the lives of the saints who have gone before us. Because makita nimo ang common patterns, ilahang mga naagihan, ilahang mga struggles, makonnect with what we are going through right now. Sila pod, most of, a lot of them are family people. some of them have full-time jobs or full-time responsibilities po. Daghan kay sila mga similarities, sila po nag-go through depression, sila po nag-go through kanang grabe kay responsibility, sila nag-go through po og persecution in different forms na ma-connect nato and how during those times na push nila ang sarili nila or gitabangan sila sa balaang espiritu to finish the work in a productive way gihapon. And it's beautiful that the very previous chapter, kaning Hebrews 11, ang gilist down sa mga tao dito. It's no coincidence that when you look at this list, these are not perfect people. Abel, Enoch, Noah, Abraham, Sarah, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, Moses, Rahab. These people have, some of them have questionable histories or ang past nila na ay mga naikawat, na ay sigipangatik, na ay nag-usurp, na ay prostitute, o na ay mga other mga history that you have been mentioned in Hebrews chapter 11, but nagpakita dere that they are called people of faith because ang faith nila have resulted in certain actions nga nag-obey sila sa Ginoo. O kung makita na to diha, if they are imperfect and daghang gisilag mga maligi pang buhat, and yet they continued on in their faith, they finished well, they are considered part of the great crowds of witnesses. When we mention witnesses, we do not mean na kanang murag they are floating above o nag-observe lang sa tang-tanang ginabuhat. We don't believe this. We don't subscribe to this type of thinking. Because we know that ang atuang faith is that we only communicate with God. Because, for example, that's why we don't believe in praying to Mary. Because if mo pray ko kay Mary karon, mo pray ka kay Mary, mag-pray mo kay Mary, and all of us are able to connect with her at the same time, it means na dili lang di ang Ginoo nga ang na-characteristic of being all-powerful because matubag ang mga pag-ampo, dili lang di ay ang Ginoo ang naay attribute of being omnipresent, naa siya everywhere, madungga niya. Di lang di siya omniscient kay ma-perceive niya ang ginahuna-huna nato. But dili niya kaya paminahuna, it's only God who can do that. That's why we only pray to God. So, ang cloud of witnesses doesn't mean na nasa di ka paminaw gatanaw sa tua, but rather, ang ilang kinabuhi, ilang gipangbuhat, ang history na gi-lay down nila para sa tua, it becomes that cloud of witnesses because we can always look back to what they have done, unsa inaagihan nila, unsa gi-go through nila. Katong mga butang na to, it impacts what we are doing now and what we are facing now. And it also is a way, kaning great cloud of witnesses, because we can see here in Ephesians chapter 2, you're no longer strangers and aliens, but you're fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God. We become house members. We become a family. We know we become part of the family of God if we put our faith in Jesus Christ, repent of our sins, and follow Him. We become one part of that big family. Pag join na to anong family, that's why it's always a great habit in our families that we build, that we have our family talks. Time nga mag-istoryahan na ita about our history, naagihan nato in our childhood, atong lolo, atong lola, people in our history. And it's always a great tradition that we do this in the family because it builds our identity. Dili importante na good things na may share, even katong mga bad habits before, unsa ipangbuhat ni lolo, unsa ipangbuhat ni lola, because those are important things. Those are important points, part in building up our whole identity. That's why we always promote here in the community that whenever we have meals together, we always see this as a great time to build the identity. That's why di na to incorporate ang mga devices, mga cell phones and mga everything else na mga distractions, mga TV while we are eating. Even at a very young age, natin tendency na bata pa lang kaayo pag mukaon kinangnan na yung cell phone in front. That matingala ka the way they react, the way they respond, magsyagit sila, musturya sila, mukatawa sila, mga reaction nila. Okay, English na nan because they're listening almost always to English things, but dili normal the way they behave. Dili socially they are not becoming independent or socially dili nila ma-develop tong skills needed because ang identity nila dili gina-build up through our discussions, our talk, our stories pag naata sa family table. Katong mga devices in front or katong mga TVs, katong nag-build silang identity which are fractured identity blocks nga dili kompleto, dili tama, dili mag-fit because that's not who they are. And so we live in a generation, a tendency na to, we don't understand the concept of being in the family of God, because in the very first place, in our own respective families, wala na nahitabo. We don't discuss, we don't talk about our history, we don't talk about kinsa ta, our life, how mother and father met, how this kinsa si lolo, kinsa si lola, and all these other things. That's important to build in kaning concept. We are a family of God and we have this long line of history kung asa ta karon. That's why it's no coincidence na katong mga strongest tribes or people who have longest ang ilahang lineage or ilahang history are people who really take pride sa ilang future. Yung sila, ang lolo ni mo sa una, ang imuhang great-grandfather or imong great-great-grandfather, sila nagsugod diri, sila nagput up dito, sa una kay ilang gibuhat. Makita nimo cultures and families who are like that are strongest in their identity. Na-absorb nila kung kinsa sila. In fact, they take pride sa ilang family name, they take pride in what they do, they take pride in how people perceive them. And kita as believers, as Christians, we also should have some pride in there, in understanding mas mulalum ato ang pagtanaw when it comes to the Bible, because we see this Bible as something na daghan kaayo tao na willingly gave up their lives just so we could have this Bible, or why we are have freedom that is a church, in a church community nga pwede ta maglingkod without any persecution, pila pud ka buka tao ang namatay and nag-suffer just so we could have that freedom. And nganong naitaos tubangan that can express or and interpret the word of God, ang scripture, and i-share sa atua, naapo na siya history. And everything else, if we learn the history, the more we go deeper and understand our identity as believers. Now, one last thing how we can redeem kaning holidays that are incoming is that to remember the past is to remind ourselves that we will become a generation's past. In the far future, di lang ato mga anak, di lang ato mga apo, but somebody in that generation moving forward, whether through our lineage, by ato ang biological line, or people that we know and then na-pass down, that we make an impact, they will refer to us karun as their past, their clouds of witnesses. And ang question always diha, you have to remember that imong actions karun actually, they build up that story of how they will perceive you. Now I'm not talking about dapat ganahan kita ng tao sa tua, dapat indot kayo, but it's securing the next generations padulong dito. One time naguli mi gigan sa Jensen, we were listening to a song and ang bridge part atong song is that it talks about that on that day na naanatan believers and we're standing before the throne of God. Na scene in my mind, na image, nga medyo na emotional gumay, because if I remember, after I die and the next generation makita na ako, God willing, ang next generation, meaning ang mga apo na ako, makita pa na ako, but after I die and then wukabalo pila pa ka centuries or millennia mo labay para mo abot sa point that the end times would really be set and then finish na tanan. Pag abot na to dito in God's kingdom, dito pa na ako makita how many generations pa. And dito ako ma-realize, mo itong second, mo itong third, mo itong fourth, mo itong fifth, and then 20, na yung mga missionaries, na yung mga pastors, na yung mga inani, na yung mga, kani yung gibuhat ng organization, kani yung language na kani gi-transcribe ang Bible to, whatever man ang impact nila in the future. And when I have that thought, when I have that image, it made me all the more na murag nadasig ko ba nga murag, pitaw no, whenever we sacrifice for our family, not financially, but kaning time na ginahatag na to, kaning effort na itong ginabutang, it's always worth it because it always impacts towards pila ka generation, di lang ni karun. Muna, it saddens me na panagsa ang mga, labi na mga papa, who only think of their responsibilities, just money, money, money. It's so single-minded, single generation-minded na karun lang. And then after na, humana. It ends there. Okay lang, wala ko para sa anak para makahatag kong kwarta. Focus ko on giving money and securing all this. But ang identity, wani mo napasa. Ang relationship with God, wani mo napasa. Wani mo na secure na tanan. It always saddens me when that happens. Because again, dili ta single generation and we are going to be a past for them. So unsang klaseng pasta for them? Will we be people nga mayingon sila akong papa sa una, akong lolo sa una, akong grandfather mo to yung gibuhat. Therefore I will push through all the struggles and the suffering I am facing of right now. I hope you become someone that inspires them in the future. And that's why the author of Hebrews says and reminds us, let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. In a race, kapuy kaayo na. For those of you who have joined marathons, and sometime along the way, per mile or per 2 miles, na itaon na mo hatag sa imong water, na itaon na mo hatag ice water sa imo or bottled water para samtang gadagan ka, gaapas ka sa oras, you can drink or pwede na mo ibuhos imong ulo pag init kaayo. And the great clouds of fitnesses in our past are like that. They are handing out, naana sila uban, naana dito sa 2 kilometer, uban, naana sa 4 kilometer, uban, naana sa 6 kilometer. Nagulat sila sa tua. That's why we run. Magpadayon ta, we run through because na yung nagulat dito that if we just persevere, if we just continue just a little more, unahan na na ay bottle of water that will give us strength once again and a push to the next lap. This is not a solo race. This is a marathon with a lot of witnesses and bystanders and people who are willing to help as long as we continue on, because it's not only for our lifetime, but it's for the multiple lifetimes of the next few generations nagsunod sa atua. That's why Paul reminds us, do you not know in a race all the runners run, but only one receives the prize. So run that you may obtain it. Obviously, di lang isang madaw in this type of marathon. He was talking about something else. But this is a reminder for us that when we run, when we push through in our life, we think of having a prize. And ang prize para sa tua in this topic, in this context, is that ang next generation, ang next 2 generations, ang next 3 generations will be able to use us as an inspirational people or grandfather or great-grandfather figure na kamo to maka-inspire sa ila whenever they start their race as well. I hope and I pray that is our reminder for us to be motivated na muatubang taan yung mga holidays, not simply for entertainment, not simply para mag-relax, magkaon, magsuroy, but let's use those time to really empower and strengthen ang atuang mga relationships, not only for God, but also for the present generations and for the future generations. Let's all pray. Lord God, thank you for a reminder para sa amua. Thank you for giving us this long weekend, this long holiday. Thank you for allowing us to use this time para gamito na mo ni to remember the people who have come before us and to remember as well na in the future kami na po na may mong past nila. Allow us to be strengthened, allow us to be encouraged na magpadayon o mag-learn more about our past, our history. We thank you with that in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
This is my daily bread.
hearts, Lord. We want to yearn, Lord, burn us with passion over you, Jesus. Lord, over our passions, Lord Jesus. May it be only you, Lord. Only you.